So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And guys, most of the students, a lot of students in fact, ask a question regularly that whether I am covering all the questions from the PIB or not. So guys, all the news from the PIB are not important for our exam. We are focusing on RBI and NABARD ka economics and social issues wala part. So I only take that part which is relevant for the economics and social issues of both the exams of RBI and NABARD. Alright, so I hope you all have got the answer now. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And you can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Alright, so let's begin with the very first question. Which of the following is correct statement regarding reissuance of overseas citizens of India card according to the new provision declared in the month of April 2021? So overseas citizens of India card holders ke liye naye provisions launch kiye hain government ne in this month only. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding this new provision. Now first of all, who are the overseas citizens of India? Sabse pehle overseas of citizens of India kaun hote hain? Overseas of citizens of India, citizenship of India, basically guys, it is a permanent citizenship. It is a permanent citizenship given to the persons of Indian origin, given to the persons of Indian origin who have the passport of some other country. Aise persons of Indian origin को permanent citizenship दी जाती है जिनके पास किसी दूसरी country का passport होता है. They enjoy almost every right that is being enjoyed by the citizen of India, but there are some exceptions, like they do not have the right to vote. इनके पास right to vote नहीं होता. They cannot buy agricultural land in our country, and they also cannot avail some of the government services which are listed under the Citizenship Amendment Act of 2005 if the person is an overseas citizen of India card holder. Now there are another kind of citizenship which is known as PIO, persons of Indian origin. Now PIO, persons of Indian origin, guys, are those persons who had at any time held Indian passport, jinke paas kisi bhi samay Indian passport tha, and or either his parents, his or her parents or grandparents or great grandparents were a citizen of India under the Citizenship Amendment Act of 1955 at any point of time. Okay, let me repeat this. So person of Indian origin are those person who had at any time had the Indian passport, or their parents or their grandparents or their great grandparents were the citizens of India under the Citizenship Amendment Act of 1955. Now, what is the difference? What is the basic difference between PIO and OCI card holders? So guys, the big difference between OCI card holders and the PIO is that a PIO, if coming to India, agar koi person of Indian origin India aa raha hai, then he or she can stay only for maximum 180 day. After that, he or she has to register himself or herself at FRRO. What is FRRO? Foreigner Regional Registration Office. Okay. लेकिन जो ओवरसीज सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया होते हैं उनको पूरा इंडेफिनेटली इंडिया में रहने का अधिकार है इफ द पर्सन इज एन ओसीआई कार्ड होल्डर. ओके, सो आई होप गाइस ओसीआई एंड पीआईओ द डिफरेंस इज क्लियर. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस न्यू दिस न्यूज. सो यूनियन होम मिनिस्ट्री विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर अमित शाह द मोटा भाई हैज क्लैरिफाइड दैट द ओवरसीज सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया विल नॉट बी रिक्वायर्ड टू रजिस्टर फॉर अ फ्रेश ओसीआई कार्ड एवरी टाइम अ न्यू पासपोर्ट इज इशूड इन देयर नेम. अगर किसी ओसीआई कार्ड होल्डर के नाम में एक नया पासपोर्ट इशू होता है तो उसको ओसीआई कार्ड को रीइश्यू कराने की जरूरत नहीं है. बट इससे पहले जो प्रोविजन था, बिफोर दिस द ओसीआई कार्ड इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी रीइश्यूड ईच टाइम अ न्यू पासपोर्ट इज इशूड अप टू 20 इयर्स ऑफ एज एंड वंस आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग 50 इयर्स ऑफ एज. इससे पहले क्या होता था कि जो ओसीआई कार्ड को रीइश्यू कराना पड़ता था अगर कोई नया पासपोर्ट इशू होता है अप टू 20 इयर्स ऑफ एज, और एक बार कराना पड़ता था वंस आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग आफ्टर द पर्सन हैज कंप्लीटेड 50 इयर्स ऑफ एज. ऑलराइट, नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द लेटेस्ट चेंजेस द न्यू प्रोविजंस. नाउ अ पर्सन हैज गॉट रजिस्ट्रेशन एज ओसीआई कार्ड होल्डर प्रायर टू अटेनिंग द एज ऑफ 20 इयर्स. अगर किसी पर्सन के पास ओसीआई कार्ड होल्डर अगर कोई पर्सन ओसीआई कार्ड होल्डर है बिफोर ही हैज अटेन्ड द एज ऑफ 20 इयर्स, then he or she will have to get the OCI card reissued only once when a new passport is issued after his or completing 20 years of age, so as to capture his or her facial features on attaining adulthood. So basically क्या है, 20 साल से पहले पहले अगर OCI कार्ड इशू हो चुका है और 20 साल और उसके बाद एक नया पासपोर्ट इशू होता है तो 20 साल की उम्र के बाद उसको केवल एक बार अपना OCI कार्ड जो है वो रीइशू कराना पड़ेगा. एंड इफ अ पर्सन हैज ऑब्टेन्ड रजिस्ट्रेशन एज OCI कार्ड होल्डर आफ्टर ही और शी हैज अटेन्ड द 20 इयर्स ऑफ एज देन देयर विल बी नो रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ रीइशू ऑफ द OCI कार्ड अगर कोई नया पासपोर्ट इशू होता है तब भी. सो आई होप गाइस दिस इज क्लियर. And now there are some exceptions also. So anyone who is applying for OCI card, of course, should hold a valid passport of another country. Only then he or she will follow the definition of OCI. Individuals who do not have citizenship of any other country are not eligible to gain an OCI status because this is according to the definition of OCI under the Citizenship Amendment Act of 1955. And of course, the individuals whose parents or grandparents hold citizenship of Pakistan or Bangladesh are not eligible to apply. Or if the individual himself is a citizen of Pakistan or Bangladesh, cannot apply for the OCI. Okay. So this was about this news, guys. Now let's come to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. OCI card is required to be reissued each time a new passport is issued up to 20 years of age. No, that is incorrect. This was the old provision. OCI card is required to be reissued only once at the time a new passport is issued after 20 years of age. So if a person is a OCI card holder after attaining 20 years of age, then there is no need of reissuance of OCI card if a new passport is issued in his or her name. All right. And OCI card is required to be reissued at the time a new passport is issued after 50 years of age. Yes, this is absolutely correct. So only three will be the correct answer. Option B, only three will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. India and Dash have signed an agreement on technical cooperation titled as Cities Combating Plastic Entering the Marine Environment, whose outcomes are completely in line with the objectives of Swachh Bharat Mission Urban, which is focused on sustainable solid waste management. So guys, we have discussed it a lot of time that the Swachh Bharat Mission Urban has now shifted its focus from sustainable solid waste management. All right. And it's Germany. India and Germany have signed an agreement on technical cooperation, which is titled as Cities Combating Plastic Entering the Marine Environment. All right. Now, the name says is all. The name, iske naam se hi hame iska objective aur iska jo aim hai wo pata chal jata hai. So the project, guys, is aimed at enhancing practices to prevent plastic entering the marine environment. मरीन एनवायरनमेंट में प्लास्टिक को एंटर करने से रोकने के लिए दिस एग्रीमेंट हैज बीन साइंड बिटवीन इंडिया एंड जर्मनी. नाउ दिस इनिशिएटिव और यू कैन से दिस एग्रीमेंट और दिस इवेंट विल बी अंडरटेकन एट द नेशनल लेवल बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स बाय सम इट विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज एट सम ऑफ द सिलेक्टेड स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज विच आर उत्तर प्रदेश केरला एंड अंडमान एंड निकोबार आइलैंड एंड ऑल्सो इन सम ऑफ द सिलेक्टेड सिटीज विच आर कानपुर कोची एंड पोर्ट ब्लेयर फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 3.5 ईयर्स. 3.5 साल के लिए इस पूरे के पूरे इनिशिएटिव को कैरी ऑन किया जाएगा इन द सिलेक्टेड स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज एंड इन द सिलेक्टेड सिटीज. एंड रिमेंबर एट द नेशनल लेवल इट विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स. ऑलराइट. नाउ टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट दिस प्रोजेक्ट. सो दिस प्रोजेक्ट गाइज इज अ पार्ट ऑफ रीजनल कोऑपरेशन बिटवीन द टू कंट्रीज इन द फील्ड ऑफ प्रिवेंशन ऑफ मरीन लिटर दैट वॉज साइंड बिटवीन द टू कंट्रीज इन 2019. एक दोनों कंट्रीज के बीच में अग्रीमेंट हुआ था इन द फील्ड ऑफ प्रिवेंशन ऑफ मरीन लिटर, उसके तहत इस प्रोजेक्ट को लॉन्च किया गया है. एंड ये क्वेश्चन में ही हमने पढ़ लिया था दैट दिस प्रोजेक्ट इज इन लाइन विद द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ स्वच्छ भारत मिशन अर्बन. ऑलराइट. सो देयरफॉर गाइस द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट, ऑप्शन बी, जर्मनी. जर्मनी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. इन जर्मनी चांसलर इज एंजेला मर्कल इज द चांसलर ऑफ जर्मनी एंड शी वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन टू बिकम द चांसलर ऑफ जर्मनी. ऑलराइट. सो ऑप्शन बी, जर्मनी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Question number 3 is, for what purpose online grievance management portal of National Commission for Scheduled Castes portal has been launched. So you have the question asked about the purpose of this online grievance management portal of National Commission for Scheduled Castes. Remember guys, National Commission for Scheduled Castes was set up under Article 338 of the Constitution of India to safeguard the constitutional and all the legal rights of the scheduled caste community in our country. And we also have a National Commission for STs. National Commission for ST is under Article 338A, and we also have a National Commission for Backward Classes under Article 338B. All right, so you should remember the article of these important organizations also. Now, the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, which is headed by Mr. Thawarchand Gehlot. Who is the minister? It's Thawarchand Gehlot, and he is also the leader in Rajya Sabha, as we all know. So this ministry has launched the online grievance management portal of National Commission for Scheduled Castes, and this is for registering and this is for registration of complaints against the atrocities against scheduled caste communities in our country. हमारे देश के जो scheduled caste community के लोग हैं उनके खिलाफ उनके against अगर कुछ atrocities होती है तो उसके against complaint register करने के लिए this portal has been launched. And it has been designed by Bhaskaracharya Institute for Space Application and Geoinformatics. Remember this also. It is a center of excellence under the Ministry of Electronics and IT. And as I told you, it is for submission of complaints about atrocities against citizens belonging to the scheduled caste. It will facilitate an end-to-end e-filing of complaints. इसमें e-filing होगी because obviously it is a portal. It is a portal, so there should be e-filing of complaints only. And it is intended to make the hearing process work on similar lines as e-courts. E-courts ke accordingly isme kaam kiya jayega. Alright. So this was about this news, and I hope you can easily answer this question now. The purpose has been asked. So it is for complaining about atrocities against citizens who belong to the scheduled caste. Option D here is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. The first of its kind conference on hydrogen ecosystem, hydrogen economy, the Indian Dialogue 2021. Took place on 15th of April 2021. Which of the following is not correct about this hydrogen roundtable conference or the dialogue? So let's discuss about this, and question number 5 is also based on this. So it was the first edition of hydrogen roundtable, which was titled as Hydrogen Economy, the Indian Dialogue 2021. It took place in a virtual mode on 15th of April 2021. And remember, it was first of its kind conference on hydrogen ecosystem. Remember this. Pehla aisa tha. जो कि इसमें जो कि हाइड्रोजन इकोसिस्टम पे फोकस था, एंड 25 पार्टिसिपेंट्स फ्रॉम 15 कंट्रीज पार्टिसिपेटेड. ऑलराइट, 25 पार्टिसिपेंट्स थे इसमें फ्रॉम 15 कंट्रीज हु पार्टिसिपेटेड इन दिस इनॉग्रल एडिशन ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन इकोनॉमी इंडिया डायलॉग 2021. नाउ व्हाट वाज द पर्पस? टू डिस्कस इमर्जिंग हाइड्रोजन इकोसिस्टम्स एंड एक्सप्लोरिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर कोलैबोरेशन, कोऑपरेशन एंड कोएलिशन. हाइड्रोजन को हम कैसे एक एफिशिएंट फ्यूल की तरह यूज कर सकते हैं, हाउ वी कैन यूज हाइड्रोजन एज एन एफिशिएंट फ्यूल. फॉर दैट, फॉर डिस्कसिंग दिस डायलॉग वाज हेल्ड. ऑलराइट, एंड इट वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय द एनर्जी फोरम एंड द फेडरेशन ऑफ इंडियन पेट्रोलियम इंडस्ट्री विच वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैस. एंड इट वॉज लेड बाय श्री धर्मेंद्र प्रधान, हु इज द इंडियन मिनिस्टर फॉर पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैस एंड स्टील. And guys, these are some of the broad objectives of this dialogue. Number one is to estimate the progress of hydrogen ecosystem. Puri duniya mein hydrogen ecosystem kitna progress kar raha hai. Assessing the potential of green hydrogen. Green hydrogen ke kya potential hote hain? Because we all know that hydrogen is a fuel which releases no emission. Koi emission nahi hota usme. Sharing learnings of creating a hydrogen ecosystem and best practices. Exchanging views on the different technologies which can boost up the hydrogen production in all the countries. Discuss on policy roadmaps and mapping demand and supply of hydrogen. So these were some of the basic objectives. And guys, agar hum hydrogen ki baat kar rahe hain, so we should talk about US-India Hydrogen Task Force that will be launched soon under the Strategic Energy Partnership by both the countries, US and India. This task force, guys, will help in scaling up technologies to produce hydrogen from the renewable energy sources. ये जो task force है, ये क्या करेगा? ये technologies को scale up करने में, develop करने में help करेगा, जिन technologies से हम hydrogen produce कर सकते हैं. We can produce hydrogen from the renewable sources and the fossil fuel sources also. And it will definitely help in bringing down the cost of deployment of enhanced energy security and resiliency, because we all know hydrogen as a fuel is very, very much costly. All right. And India has a H2 Alliance also, which is known as India H2 Alliance. It is an industry coalition of global and Indian companies. Ye ek industrial coalition hai of the global and Indian companies committed to the creation of a hydrogen value chain and economy of India. Economy in India, creation of a hydrogen value chain and economy in India. Uske liye ye India H2 Alliance hai, and it is, remember, it is an alliance of global and Indian companies which are focused on the creation of a hydrogen value chain and economy in our country. All right. And of course, we should talk about the National Hydrogen Energy Mission, which was launched this year, which was announced this year in the Union Budget 2021-22. It is focused on generation of hydrogen from green power resources and to link India's growing renewable capacity with the hydrogen economy. And for this mission, rupees 1500 crores were allotted in the Union Budget 2021-22. All right, so you should remember that National Hydrogen Energy Mission was announced in the Union Budget 2021-22 this year, and rupees 1500 crores was allotted to this mission. All right, so this was about this news, and now let's come back to question number 4 and 5. So you have to identify the not correct statement about hydrogen roundtable. So it was organized by the Energy Forum and Federation of Indian Petroleum Industry. Yes, this is absolutely correct, and it was led by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan. The main focus is on policy roadmaps and mapping demand and supply of hydrogen. Yes, this is also correct. And 25 panelists from 15 countries participated in the dialogue. Yes, as I told you, this is also correct, which means all are correct, should be the correct answer. Koi bhi incorrect statement nahi hai isme. And now let's move ahead to question number 5. Hydrogen is gaining increasing importance as a source to bridge energy gaps and also as a standalone source to conventional fuels. Which of the following is not correct about the steps taken by India towards changing itself as a hydrogen economy? Option A is India and USA will launch a hydrogen task force. Yes, we have discussed this. India has made an alliance, IH2A. The Union Budget for 2021-22 has announced a National Hydrogen Energy Mission. This is also correct. An amount of rupees 1500 crores was allocated for renewable energy development and National Hydrogen Mission in this year's budget. So all the statements are correct, which means option E should be the correct answer. India and Germany will also launch a hydrogen task force. No, aisi announcement abhi tak nahi hui hai. In future hogi to dekha jayega. All right, so option E here is the correct answer. So guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.